Let's do car maintenance today. This is the engine oil. This is the fuel filter. Which filters the fuel, petrol or diesel. This is the in and this is the out. The spark plug. And the air filter. It's the old one and new one. You can see the old one, a lot of dirt, and this is the engine oil filter. So every time we change the engine oil, we need to change the filter. So we are taking out the spark plugs. So you can see there's a carbon deposit with the spark plugs. These old ones, so we will replace them with the new ones. This is how we place the spark plugs. The spark head is at the bottom, which sits over the engine section. This is a throttle body spray cleaner. So basically, instead of taking the whole throttle body out and cleaning it, we can just spray it. Just make sure the spark plugs are tight enough. These are the ignition coils. Put the ignition coils. These are the ignition coils, so we have to put them in their respective slots. So there are two ignition coils and four spark plugs for the 16 valve 4 stroke car engine. Tighten the ignition coils and make sure all the wire connections are right, otherwise the spark won't happen and the combustion won't happen inside the combustion chamber on the engine or the engine. So this is the bottom of the car. We are taking out the old engine oil filter. This is the bottom of the car. And so this is a small tub in which we need to pour down the old engine oil. So this is the bottom side of the engine, and once we open the air, this engine oil filter, the old engine oil, it pours down and we have put a tub, and this is a new one. So we tap it in and then tight it up with a special kind of mechanism, a tool to screw up our the engine oil filter. That's it. This is how I fixed it again back. This is a new one. That's the old engine oil that we collected in a tub. Tighten up the chambers so that no leaks coming out of the chamber. Now coming back to the top of the engine, we take out the cap, and now this is the engine oil, a new engine oil. We pour it slowly inside the engine through this slot. Cap it up. We usually have to change the engine oil every time we see the viscosity. This is the scale to check the amount. This is the maximum and minimum, so it tells us the amount that we are left with. And this is the throttle body cleaner spray. That's the opening mouth of the throttle body. So manually we are pressing the clutch wire, pulling the clutch wire, so that when it, every time we accelerate, the cap opens. You can see there's a sort of cap which opens every time we pull the accelerator wire. So that lets the amount of air to go inside the throttle body. So every time we open the cap with the help of pulling the accelerator wire, we spray it with the sprayer. It goes in and wash the carbon. So we now putting back the filter body assembly. This is the filter body assembly. See, it's a lot of dirt inside. So screw up the filter body assembly back in its original position. This is the new air filter. So we replace the old one with the new one. Closing the filter body assembly cap. Lock it. Make sure all the screws are tight enough. There are no loose hoses or pipes. Otherwise, there will be imbalance of intake and output of the air. Okay, now we gonna, with the help of a jack, we gonna pull the car up. This is a fuel filter. Fuel means water, whether you are using petrol or diesel. So we need to change it whenever it's old. So we're gonna pull the clamps with the help of a plier. So these clamps are holding the pipes, which is in pipe and out pipe of the fuel. One side of the fuel pump where the fuel enters is the in, and from the other side it's out. So that's the out. So this pipe or hose, so this is the fuel coming out, that's petrol. Now we need to take the filter out. This is the bottom side of the vehicle. So with the correct tool, we need to open the bolt which is holding the fuel filter. Well, this is a 12 mm bolt opener. This is a new fuel filter. So after taking out the old one, we're gonna put the new fuel filter. Again, we're gonna tighten up the bolts which is holding the fuel filter. Make sure that it fits. And now we will put back the fuel pipes, connect them to the new fuel filter, and make sure we clamp them with the clamps tightly so that there is no leakage of the fuel through the fuel filter. So now our fuel filter installed. That's a 12 mm nut opener. That's 12 mm, and that was our old fuel filter. And just tighten up the fuel cap back, which we actually opened. So, good work done.